Second trip, 1,400 Canadian pesos.
We're gonna put an Olympic barbell and load it up with some weights and show it curl a couple hundred pounds. Hey guys, it's time to install the hydraulics and test the power loader's upper body. But first, I do have some bad news. Due to the global pandemic we're all facing, this may be the last power loader update for a little while, as most of our company's working from home and we won't be able to continue working on it. The following video was shot shortly before Canada sent people home to help flatten the curve. You can do your part to help flatten the curve as well by staying at home and only going out for necessities. But I do have something you can do while you're staying at home. This video is sponsored by Hustle Castle. It's a ridiculously fun game that I've been playing. Uh-oh. Woo-hoo. It's a free mobile castle building game where you expand and upgrade your castle, attack the fortresses of other players, and steal their resources. Now's your chance to become the Lord of Medieval Castle. I've always wanted to be a sire. What I really like about this game is its cartoony art style that makes it funny to watch your people interact. You can zoom into different castle rooms to see what your characters are up to, which I haven't seen in a game before. You can train and develop your characters with different classes like archers, mages, carpenters, and even alchemists to make resources. You can upgrade your character's skills and weapons to battle giants, orcs, skeletons, and even dragons to defeat the demonic Abyss Lord. Find my clan under the Hacksmith and join it to play with me today. You can support our channel and projects just like this by downloading Hustle Castle today via my links below. If you enter your nickname, you get a special bonus for new players, 250 diamonds and 3,500 gold. Now, let's go test the power loader. But first, we're gonna need to go on a little shopping trip.
What's the problem, Bogdan?
We don't have the big cylinder that we need.
What are we looking for? Five? Tier 2, right? Isn't that big enough?
Yes, but it's gotta be a third that way.
Oh, they don't have them, Bogdan.
They're not.
4,008. 50,24.
Uh-oh. 4,014. 3,16. 3,508. 3,08.
Yay, they had one in stock.
So hard to carry with one hand. My God, look at this thing.
I've been making these. Literally, exactly what I needed.
Two sixes.
So, which means we need even more 2 feet, and more 3 feet.
Do we have no fittings?
That's about half of what we actually need.
Do they sell that here? Looks like we'll have to hit up another Princess Auto for the next city. 4008 or 5008 or 3008?
4008
of our shopping cart.
But also, look at this.
Second trip, 1,400 Canadian pesos. There it is.
Juji, if you can pick this up.
Yeah. Oh my gosh!
What? The Grip Genie granted my grip wish, and he'll grip yours too.
Thank you, Grip Genie.
Thank you, Grip Genie.
Can you believe?
A redder engine. That's gonna be another like 10 grand for a good engine.
Finally done assembling the back and the shoulders of our Alien's power loader, which means the next steps are just to prime the hydraulic system and to get the whole thing tested. Here's our entire system for the hydraulics. We'll start with the car batteries. Here we have three car batteries, which are going to supply the power for the entire system. We've got our motor, hydraulic pump, and hydraulic reservoir here to actually flood the entire system with oil. Our two T's that split the drain and the pressure across to the two valve blocks here and here. The two bottom ones control the bicep cylinders for the left and the right arm. The two middle ones control our laterals, and then the two top ones will control our back muscles to allow the arms to pan in and out. This is an antique switch box that someone donated to us, and we're going to be using it as a temporary way to control the power loader and to test all the arms and all the linkages. Okay, so basically my plan, since there's two sides of it, is just to use one half of these for the left arm and one half of these for the right. And we got 8 switches on each. Currently we're using 6 valves per arm. But what we can do is we can have one of these be for the back panning in and out, one of these for the lateral, and then one of these for the bicep, and then just mirror it on the other side. And then the bottom row will be for the wrist forward and back, the wrist rotation, and then the gripper open and close. And even some of these switches like this, we can use that to engage and disengage the pump.
Awesome.
So.
Let's get testing.
Yeah, let's do it. Okay, so we've tested all the switches and we've gotten all the air out of the system. We're ready to move on to the actual load testing, but we should probably check to make sure that our motor isn't getting too hot because it's kind of undersized for this application. Can you see how the motor's getting?
You can see right here on the motor is the hottest point, which all things considered isn't terrible for an electric motor. But the nice thing with using a thermal camera like this is you can see from a distance that there's a bit of an issue there. So fun fact about these thermal imagers, when I was back in school, you could not get one of these things for less than like $10,000, which is incredible that these have come down to just a few hundred dollars now online, which is super convenient for us because we can actually make use of it when we're doing our engineering projects like this. We've got basically the whole upper body done now, right Bogdan? Which means we can start testing it. So I think one of the first tests should be, let's see if we can do the iconic Sigourney Weaver come at me when she attacks the alien for the first time. So one issue we have right now is because this isn't the finalized valve bank or pump situation, hydraulics flow where there's least resistance. So as you can see, sometimes one arm drops while the other lifts, and that's because all the flow is going into the easiest path of least resistance, which then drops the other arm. So we actually have to kind of like go like left and right to be able to almost get a smooth motion going. We won't have that issue in the final design, but that's after we've added a whole bunch more hydraulic valves and possibly even multiple pumps. All right, let's open her up. It just wants a hug.
Come on!
Come at me! We're gonna put an Olympic barbell through these two holes and load it up with some weights and show it curl a couple hundred pounds. Let's go grab some weights. All right. Let's grab all the 45s we have. At least two, because I remember I got at least two 45, four 45s because I was ambitious and I'm like, someday I'll be able to do 225. Again, grab all the 35s. Perfect. All right, let's start loading her up. All right, so that's 275 pounds. That's actually the same weight that my pneumatic-based exoskeleton curled like 5 years ago. The moral of the story is we need more weight.
There it is.
He was just pressing the button. There we go. So right now, this is 275 pounds, and we're adding another 320. Yeah! Yeah, look at that strength! And now pull-ups, Ian. Pull-ups. Woo! Wait. Same time. Not bad. Now, a big thing to note, you might be thinking, it's so slow. That's because we're using a tiny 12 volt test hydraulic pump. This is in no way how fast it will be when we're done. The restricting factor right now is flow rate. So a tiny motor can't make that much flow with the hydraulic fluid, which means it's gonna move slowly. These cylinders and even the hoses are rated for a flow well over 10 to 20 times as much as we're showing right now. So it will actually be able to go, no problem. So
So one of the nightmares of doing a complex hydraulic system is hose management, of which we have none right now. So as you can see, some of these hoses are getting pretty bent, which is a no-no for hydraulics. But we just wanted to see if the actual design works before we send it out to actually get painted, and then we can worry about actually routing this quite nicely. So for example, we're probably gonna wanna rotate all these fittings up and down. We're gonna wanna actually make use of hose clamps mounted to the body to make sure the hoses stay where they're supposed to be. But if we do it right, we're gonna have a real life power loader. I mean, looking at the doll, like it's, I don't know about you, Bogdan, but I think we're pretty accurate right now.
Oh, yeah.
A few just not even plugged in. It's great. All right, this is freaking awesome. We have the upper body to our very own Aliens Power Loader mech. The next step for our power loader build is to take it all apart again and send it out to be professionally painted a nice caterpillar yellow. After that, we're gonna be trying to get a caterpillar skid steer with a tank tread base to complete this mech. So make sure you subscribe with notifications turned on. This is just the beginning of our awesome project, and you don't wanna miss it.